So 2021 was not great, but not really awful either. It was a pretty meh year, all things considered. Or maybe it's just because a lot of the bad things in 2021 were leftovers from previous years that still haven't been solved. NFTs, the Rona, the alt-right. But on the plus side, not only did we get some pretty great video games this year, but for the first time, we actually have a vaccine for malaria. Granted, it should have come out a lot sooner, but hey, progress is progress. And personally, the year was a pretty big milestone for me since I spent half of it, for the first time, in my own place. Now, granted, said place was pretty fraught with issues, as you can hear in some of the videos I put out, but hopefully that situation will be remedied next year. But this isn't about me. Because while malaria might have its own vaccine now, albeit not a 100% effective one, but still, for other diseases like HIV, we aren't so lucky. 2021 marks the 40th anniversary of the first reported HIV-related death on June 5th, 1981. According to the Department of Health and Human Services, it's estimated that 38 million people in the world are currently living with HIV, including 1.2 million in the United States alone. But there is good news. According to the CDC, in 2019, 66% of people with diagnosed HIV were virally suppressed. And the number of estimated annual infections has decreased dramatically from 130,000 in the mid-80s to 34,800 in 2019. In 40 years, we've gotten a lot closer to ending the HIV epidemic once and for all. But we can't rest easy just yet. That's why this year, as I have for several years now, I'm encouraging all of you to join Red Ribbon Reviewers. Which, come to think of it, the project actually turns 11 this year. I didn't even realize that last year was the 10th anniversary because last year was. Yeah. Regardless, Red Ribbon Reviewers was a project that started thanks to Stephen James back in 2010. However, after he went into retirement, since I was a friend of his, I took up the mantle and I've been hosting it ever since. I started running Red Ribbon Reviewers back in 2012, and I don't intend to stop anytime soon. And if you want to be a part of this project, here's how. If you are a video producer, promote the project in your videos in December, usually by wearing the Red World AIDS Day ribbon or just by putting it in the corner through editing. If you don't make videos, no problem. Written and audio content are also accepted, you just need to promote the project. It's not necessary, but I also recommend promoting an actual HIV charity, though please try and vet your choice before you do. I recommend charities like the Black AIDS Institute, AIDS United, Broadway Cares, or the Elton John AIDS Foundation, but there are plenty of others. Link any content to me, whether it's in the comments of this video or on the Red Ribbon Reviewers Twitter or Facebook page, which you can find in the description. Once you do, your content will be posted to the official Red Ribbon Reviewers website. This way, you'll not only entertain people, but you'll be doing it for a good cause. Everyone deserves to have a safe and happy holiday season, especially in a world that's already in the throes of one pandemic, and you can help. With that said, I'm the hero of tomorrow, and I look forward to the content you submit this year.